some months ago, I made already some videos about the legal name. Ya hace algunos meses he hecho algunos videos sobre el nombre legal. And these days I watch some more videos about Kate of Gaia. Estos días he mirado algunos videos más de Kate of Gaia, who especially important the video Babylon is Fallen. El video más importante se llama Babylon is Fallen. So especially this time, I want to remember if we use the legal name, it's actually a copyright infringement. Si usamos el nombre legal, es una infracción de derechos de autores, because it is registered under the crown, porque está registrado. I have listened already to many videos of Kate of Gaia, but today, finally, I saw her for the first time. Ya he escuchado ya muchos videos de Kate of Gaia, pero hoy la primera vez que la he visto. And I was surprised. And now I understand her much better, because actually I think she was born male and she converted. She looks, of course, like a real woman, but when you hear her voice, you're surprised as me. Así que hoy la he visto por primera vez y ahora la entiendo mucho mejor, porque ha nacido de hombre, ha convertido transvestir, y sí, por el tema del nombre legal la entiendo mucho mejor ahora. Actually, I wanted to make video. Today is fiesta en la playa, but I had moved so much furniture the last time. I don't find my things. Realmente quería hacer video ahí en la playa, que hay fiesta. Pero último tiempo que he movido tanto muebles por el proyecto CCBP Canarias Crypto Bitcoin P2P. That's why I moved this furniture to prepare that. But actually, as you maybe listened to the last video, which number? I think 42, Innocent CryptoKitty number 42. I should translate that Babylon is fallen. Debería traducir este Babylon is Fallen video, but actually I prefer to record when I walk, because at home I like to watch videos and do other things, porque en casa prefiero mirar videos haciendo otras cosas, multitasking. I should find a way to do this when I go for a walk at the beach. Debería encontrar una manera para hacer esto cuando voy de paseo en la playa. A ver si hay alguna manera. Actually, I'm quite satisfied with this voice recorder of Sony. The battery is taking already long time. And realmente estoy satisfecha con este voice recorder de Sony. Si me acuerdo bien, 60 euros Carrefour. If I remember well, 60 euros Carrefour. Aquí, Gran Canaria. I was using sometimes the tablet voice recorder, but if the sun shines, it's really difficult. you almost don't see, and with the voice recorder you can feel the button make pause. Antes había también utilizado algunas veces el tablet, pero es malo, pues si hay el sol casi no se ve, y con este aparato se siente el botón. Okay, let's go to back to that legal name. Vamos a volver al tema de nombre legal. There are somebody's made some good videos too. It begins with the name with B, YouTube channel, and number 17 or something. Barney F. Don't remember exactly, but he made really good videos about it. Ah, había otro canal de YouTube que empieza con B y un número 700, no me acuerdo bien. Pero, remember, because at the birth, they take your DNA. When you're born, the rest of cuando los bebés nacen, cogen el DNA. DNA, AND, ¿cómo se llama en español? Que es la prueba de tu identidad, the proof of your identity. So using that legal name as a trap in court, you better just, maybe better if you go to court, better say, first of all, I'm here against my will. Si te vas al juicio, mejor decir, estoy aquí en contra de mi voluntad. And everything we say can be and will be used against us in court of justice, or better to say corruption. Es decir, todo lo que digamos puede ser utilizado en contra de nosotros ante un tribunal de justicia, o más bien dicho, de corrupción. Justice, who has the right? Justice, who has the right to judge? Who is without sin cast the first stone? Justicia, ¿quién tiene el derecho de juzgar? ¿Quién esté sin pecado que tire la primera piedra? Innovation and freedom of expression is inhibited by the perverse law of intellectual property. Innovación y libertad de expresión es inhibida por la ley perversa de la propiedad intelectual. If you like liberty, use Creative Commons and cryptocurrency, for example, Bitcoin. Si te gusta la libertad, usa Creative Commons y criptomoneda, cryptocurrency, por ejemplo, Bitcoin. Did you notice how often the Simpsons use examples of court comedy? ¿Te has dado cuenta cuántas veces los Simpsons usan comedia de juicios? One of my favorite episodes is when Homer Simpson sells his soul. Uno de mis episodios favoritos, es el episodio que Homer Simpson vende su alma. This and other things inspired me to create a soul trade game in Twitter, también en Facebook, Virtual Worlds. Este y otras cosas me inspiraron para crear Soul Trade Game, traducido en juego de negocio de almas, que se puede encontrar en Twitter, Facebook, bueno, es en mundos virtuales. But let's go back to court comedy. Pero volvemos a comedia de juicio. And some time ago I created the hashtag JCCVW, Abbreviation for Justice, Court, Comedy and Virtual Wars. Y también hace un tiempo he creado el hashtag JCCVW, abreviación por justicia, juicio, comedia en mundos virtuales. Because although I say this, think of this verse of the Bible, who has the right to judge, although I think there should exist a place to talk about justice and ethics. A pesar de, yo dije el versículo de la Biblia, debería haber un sitio para hablar de justicia y ética como en mundos virtuales. JCCVW. Y like in virtual worlds. Just now I am walking through Jumbo Center, the preparations for the big carnival tomorrow, Saturday. Before I start cruising Jumbo Center, lighting this. Preparaciones para todo el carnaval de la gran cabalgata mañana. And one more important thing I want to remember. What is the main reason for the crisis? Otra cosa que quiero recordar otra vez. ¿Cuál es la razón principal por la crisis? Before, there was a law that behind substituting that money must be always the same quantity of gold. Antes había una ley que detrás de cualquier cantidad de dinero había que haber oro. But this law, they took away in more or less 1930 something. They took away this law, so they had the right to print money without end. Antes había una ley. Sí, ya lo he dicho. Y luego, sí, sin esta ley tenían el derecho de imprimir dinero sin límite. This is the main reason. Es la razón principal. So that's why I'm so obsessed with cryptocurrency and Bitcoin, because it's like digital gold. Por eso también estoy tan obsesionado con el tema de cryptocurrency como Bitcoin, que es como oro digital. Just arrived at the beach, but this year it's really much less than the last years. Estoy ligado ahí a la playa, pero este año de verdad hay mucho menos que años anteriores.
So now later I will paste some more videos about legal name, Kate of Gaia. Ahora a continuación voy a pegar algunos videos más sobre el nombre legal, especialmente de Kate of Gaia, entonces Babylon is Fallen, principalmente en inglés.
Babylon is Fallen by Kate of Gaia. 1. Name. The master key to the entire system's Crown Corporation's game. The name is the linchpin to the entire legal control construct. Without a legal name, which is your consent by agreeing to be said name, the system vampires cannot literally feed on your lifeblood, creation source energy, that is typically shown in the physical materials we collect. It is only the consent to be, use, or have a legal name, mark of the beast, that is required for your absolute spiritual contract, deal with the devil motif, to be in full force and effect, with you as a slave and them as master. For proof of this, look and see how much of your life or existence involves a legal name, and you will see the measure of control the system has over you. 2. Register, registration, etc. Any and all things registered are fully surrendered with consent to the Crown Corporation with no legal recourse until such things are removed by exposing the intent by those who serve the Crown Corporation to commit fraud knowingly or unknowingly. Example, a child that is registered is Crown property. By ignorant consent, where the truth of registering was not brought forth, which is the original intent by Crown Corporation servants' owners, to have people offer their children unknowingly into slavery of soul and thus body. It's the soul they're really after, so keep that in mind. 3. Money, gold, silver, assets, Bitcoin, etc. are all illusions of value where you are the true creator of all physical manifestations. Money, external value, has been the tool as a third-party interloper, middleman, that has made draining your power possible. Money or the like only has a value if one has been duped into thinking it does. This illusion is the ultimate distraction and destroyer of creator souls, literally. All money is based on the soul contract, commonly known as a birth certificate. 4. Birth certificate. The original sin contract. The name you think or claim as yours is not your creation. Your assumed name was created by your parents or family members or adoptive kin, not you. This is an original creation manifested by another that is in turn registered, thus rendering it Crown Corporation property, as previously stated. It is upon this deception that your literal soul was and is enslaved, and upon which all money and debt is created. A debt bond value is placed in the birth certificate based on the assumed accruement of taxes, loans, debts a child is expected to pay as long as they are part of this fraud upon humanity. Example, if someone is expected to pay a certain amount of taxes, etc. in their lifetime, the bond is given a debt value. A child born into a wealthy family will have a higher debt bond value than someone who is of a lesser perceived income bracket rating. This is slave trading at its finest, which divides and conquers humanity in the serf caste hierarchy system that encompasses the planet. 5. Command and control. The courts and governments are the system slaves within, bought and paid for, where the true command and control aspects are the police and military as the frontline dogs and fear contractors for those above the courts and governments, such as the banks and religions, and those that control them. The courts and governments are merely the filler for this sandwich of deception and illusion. Without the ability to contract via any and all names at the frontline level, the whole system of control is destroyed. Most importantly, those at the very top of this spiritual slavery pyramid. Without the name, all levels above are ultimately annihilated completely. 6. The Triple Crown. This consists of Rome, City of London, Crown Corporation, and Washington, D.C. They are the unholy trinity of the three in one, one in three, as illustrated clearly in the papal crown. Religion to control the beliefs, minds, and spirituality of humanity. The courts and banks to control the money and bonds, and the world police, military, to quash rebellion and act as frontline contractors of soul extractions. 7. Principalities of darkness. This is the true nature of the game that the vastness of humanity is blind to. Religions have been used to separate you from Source by making one believe God is external and use the Savior program to reinforce this. Money is the tool that is used to keep people in the physical-only realm by getting them to equate an external value on everything, where nothing would exist without the people and their creativity. Physical death and harm is the tool used to clamp down on your true essence, which is all creation itself. The tools employed are languages with the corruption of pure frequency intent, with multiple meanings of the same sounds and frequencies, using words and spellings, literally, thus dividing and conquering us and redirecting our energy into their creations and control. These entities cannot create anything since they are soulless and thus utterly powerless. They know this, and are absolutely terrified, because this spells their doom once and for all. We are life with consciousness, where these entities are consciousness without life, soul, or spirit. They are completely and solely dependent upon getting our consent or spiritual contract agreement, and this is easily achieved through the name deception, buying people off, ego comforts, etc. Their whole house of cards and pyramid is based on this fact. We are the fuel for their system and vehicle. Without spiritual fuel, they're destroyed. The biggest program that we run into with the masses is the sheer disbelief of their own power and who they truly are. A masterful job has been done to get humanity to this level of spiritual weakness and complete ignorance. This was the intent of corrupting the ancient truths, rewriting our past, and presenting this in schools, churches, and all levels of ego academia. Repeat a lie often enough, and people will believe it. It is far easier selling a giant lie to the masses than selling us one by one. The media is the main tool of thought direction and manipulation to reinforce the lies we were filled with as children and up to our current state. We have many soulless entities on this planet, with the vast majority being placed in positions of power and control, be it police, courts, media, churches, governments, schools, military, at all levels. Fear is their only tool, and once one sees their true immortal nature, one becomes untouchable, literally. The mass hypnosis of humanity is deep, and you will meet all levels of resistance from friends, family, co-workers, etc. So don't bother trying to wake the consenting to be dead. The facts to prove this are all there for all to see, so it is up to them to look, not you. Simply plant the seed and walk away. They are the same as the ones in the allegory of Noah that came to the ark too late. Let them drown. We are now at the culmination of destroying these entities once and for all, and they are pulling out all the fear porn, illusion, and desperation plugs, and in that process, they're sinking their own ship, where I merely hand them a better plug puller now. You, and only you, can save yourself, and no one else, so stop killing yourself trying. Let the dead bury the dead, and perhaps they'll get it on the next pass, but they are not your concern. Stay the course. The path home is the one of truth only, and nothing else. Your willingness to stand in truth is yours alone, and to the degree that you stand will be the same degree that you become untouchable spiritually and, as a result, physically. As above, so below, after all. There is no middle ground here. You're either in or out of Babylon. You are either master or slave, mortal or immortal. The soul, you, are infinite, where the body is merely a biological computer you operate. Your computer was infiltrated and corrupted, reptilian brainstem, fused chromosomes, and separated from the heart source mind. The soulless ones cannot experience compassion, so don't expect them to. They are the same as the Terminator droids in the movies, programmed to control and kill without remorse, and are easy to spot. They are everywhere, including your own family, friends, etc., and all you have to do is feel your way through. Let your instincts and your heart be your guide. We are clearing this reality of these parasites exponentially now, where universal law reigns supreme where none shall or can trespass. They are masters of deception, so do not let your loving compassion be used against you, something that has been their most excuse me, something that has been their most powerful tool. The Bioborg entities are already lifeless and are dependent only on being able to suck the life out of you, but like every vampire, they cannot enter your reality without an invitation. Every use of the legal name is the only invitation they need, so best cut your ties and consent with that. Just get this concept, and you have already cut the puppet strings, and your causal ability returns instantly in relation to your ability to be responsible with that ultimate of powers. To the Walking Dead, and you know what you are, your time is over. Your deceptions are powerless, and now, moment by moment, you are being erased from consciousness for the invading parasites you are. We of the living soul are awake, aware, and reclaiming our reality, where yours never existed. In short, yes, you are doomed. Have a nice day. Kate.
You're going to love this because these are questions that you need to answer for yourself if you want proof of how you're committing fraud using a legal name. Because it ain't yours. Never was. It's a Crown registered name. Doesn't belong to you.
See, even and that in itself, Kate, that's quite a damning statement, right? Mm. Is that people in general are committing fraud.
Yeah, everyone that's using a legal name is actually committing fraud by their free will choice. But here's the thing. The owners of the Crown Corporation, whatever that is, and whoever that is, I refer to it as a dark principality simply as that, the original intent to deceive your mom and dad, my mom and dad, and everyone's parents and whatever, into this fraudulent contract via deception, non-disclosure. And a fraud revealed is null and void, not pro tunc, now for then. So it removes all of the... garbage that is smeared on your soul by walking through this in ignorance. And really, it's just the ignorance that people have to get over. I've been down all of the different roads, like the gimme gimme free men on the land, gimme gimme sovereign citizens, gimme gimme patriots, and all the rest of these guys and girls that are trying to defend a position that is indefensible. Because for me, it was very simply this. You know, looking at how the courts work and you know, you look at all the innocent people that get thrown in jails for nothing and all the rest of it, and I see that simply as, well, that's dishonorable. So how am I creating more of a dishonor than they? And it's very simple, because you're using something that doesn't belong to you. It's a dead legal fiction, and you can get in all the details in that, but it's really, really quite simple. This was a lot further down than I thought, so I'm still scrolling here, almost there. Like I said, it's been a very busy... here we go. Got it. So here's a couple of simple things that people need to ask themselves, right? And the legal name is Crown property. That's a fact. What most people don't understand is that all lawyers, bar members, have to cross the Temple Bar in the City of London state, which is a country. That's why they're all foreign agents. And while you're using the legal name, you are also a citizen of the City of London. But you don't have right of copyright use. That's what a bar member gets. They get right of use of copyright. That's why only they can speak in a courtroom and stay in honor doing so, and why they want everyone else to be silent, especially people like me, because they know that if I speak, it is a real living voice in their courtroom. So here it is. And I've got so many things to share, so many people's experiences, one very recently with Mike McLean, who went from start to finish regarding the legal name, 34 days in jail, making his stand, and it was all based on, look at the insanity of this, all based on the fact that he was going to pick up his son-in-law at the airport in his son-in-law's car that had an expired tag on it, and Michael doesn't use or carry any legal identification. So it went from there to a number of conversations with him regarding what he was going to do. And I said, Michael, if there's anyone that can make this stand, you can. Because he knew, even walking into a courtroom using a legal name, you're committing fraud, false impersonation. This is how they have you in complete dishonor. You're using a legal name that doesn't belong to you. So here it is. Attention all legal remedy, free man, sovereign citizen, patriots, alternative media truthers. There are many levels to the fraud. that you won't even get past the first question with regards to any and all Crown copyrighted owned legal names. So please explain to me how using or profiting from someone else's copyrighted property material without their permission isn't fraud or theft, without a bar card. Now, claim some wealthy author's works as yours and make money from it and see what happens when they find out. You can try that for a litmus test if you're not sure how to answer. And the next question is, if all legal names are Crown copyrighted material property, and they are, look it up, and you don't have explicit permission from the owners, I never got a call, to use it unless you have been given that permission through a bar card, how do you use a legal name without committing fraud, theft, copyright infringement, false impersonation, etc.? Now take your time. If you actually have to look that up in any copyright or trust contract law book or whatever, or see if you have enough common sense to see the obvious truth. Then get back to me with any and all insane rebuttals. Live on air even. Gauntlet down for the monkey brains. Let's see them BS their way out of this one. Because you can't. Theft is theft. If you're using somebody else's property without their permission, that's called theft. It's called fraud.
And so when people sign the registration when their children are born, they don't understand that's what they're doing. Therefore, that is theft because they haven't willingly given that up, knowing full well what they're doing. Is that right?
Oh yeah, and it goes much deeper than that because the parents are likely registered as well, so they are legal name slaves to the system. It's like this headline came up yesterday or the day before. Regarding TSA is now giving amnesty to all illegals, which translated means not legals. I'm a not legal. I don't deal in illegal fiction. Whereas any American citizen must provide identification where people like me don't. So this is another unveiling of what's really going on here. I had an experience just over a week ago in a hospital where I would not relinquish. I had to go to an emergency, long story, no big deal. But I ended up at Mount Sinai Hospital in Toronto, and I would not give them a, I told them why, I will not give a legal name because it's an admission of fraud, and having had my identity stolen, and as a result of that, the Guelph City Police, for example, and the mayor, Karen Firebridge, and all of the city officials, and of course Bank of Montreal, and all of these individuals that I was calling out for their fraud came against me. And, ripped my family apart, stole my home, car, truck, and all the rest of it. So I made a choice at that point. I said, fine, you want to do that to me? Well, I'm going to take your planet. And I did. And this is how we take our planet back. It's very simple.
Right.
You know, I don't, you've heard me talk, Ava.
Yeah.
And you've heard the shows. I just don't have time for liars. I just don't have time for anyone that's still spreading lies regarding legal remedy, because all they're doing is aiding and abetting a fellow human being into bearing false witness. And that's exactly what people do to each other every day. You're bearing false witness. You are worshiping a graven image. And I can use all the Religiocosis Chosen Itis books because I know how to read them anagogically. They're not literal books. They're actually allegorical. And once you understand the allegory, then you can take it to the next level, which is anagogic.
Well, wasn't this all
simply the hive mind?
Wasn't this all? I think I heard you saying something about this is all in the Bible too. I mean, all this
stuff isn't new information. There's only one story. Yeah.
Right.
Well, it's interesting that you mentioned earlier about the whole concept of the bar,
right?
And how the lawyers are the only ones that they want to be speaking in court.
We've experienced this
firsthand, I've experienced actually. That personally through a family court issue over the last
too long.
And the last round I was completely self-represented, and when I would use their laws to record my court proceedings to supplement my notes, they did not like it.
They didn't like you speaking at all.
But they did
really
not like me speaking in court at all.
No.
And this concept here makes complete sense.
Total sense. And of course, Kate, what you would say is don't even go into court.
Oh yeah, no. Like knowing what I know now, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah, you guys know this.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
let's
yeah.
make sure that everybody else does.
Yeah. Yeah.
The last place you should ever go, and by the way, on my website is if anyone has any tickets that they think is for them, it's not. It's for the legal name, so give it back to the owner, the Crown. And I have a document that people can use. It's very simple, titled As Per Your Fraud. And what it is to let those that are trying to aid and abet you, be it a bailiff, a cop, a lawyer, a judge, or whatever in the system, trying to aid and abet you into going into court, as per your fraud. You see, what I do is I hand the fraud back. Because the original intent to register, the fact that there's a registration office on this planet, is all the proof I need that says that it was intent to deceive and defraud humanity.
So Kate, can I just jump in for a sec? Are you,
sure.
I just want to clarify. So, because I know there's people on this call or on who are watching the show who actually have tickets that they're going to have to choose whether or not to defend. And so can you just clarify, are you saying then that people do not have to, they don't have to claim those at all? They don't have to defend them? They just simply send them back?
Well, yeah, again, but it's not, see, this is where I separate the whole idea of gimme, gimme, and someone else has figured it out for me, and I'll just do that.
Right.
See, this is the problem with this. Only when you get the concept, you see, because you are the power behind your words, be they written or spoken. And if you do not understand what is on the page, if you don't have the concept of it, it's like tossing an empty grenade into the courtroom. Mm-hmm. And, of course, everyone's going to go, ooh, ah, and then when it doesn't go off,
yeah.
They go, ah. Cheeky, and I'll pick the grenade up, open it up, fill it full of gunpowder, and throw it back. So this is where you got to know yourself. And this is why I steer people directly to my website. The writings and essays and documents are all there in a very easy to understand. Basically, it's my experience laid bare as to what I was going through. You know, there's like the instance, you can get it live on YouTube. Go to Lightworkers Media. And look up the confrontation, and you'll get me on air running off three OPP officers live on air because I drive a car that has expired plates, so I want to make sure they know who they've got. That's, you know, no touch. I have no VIN in the car. I carry no ID. I'm a high-profile system mark. I mean, if you've never seen the Judge Bows to Sovereign video, well, that's me in boy mode. That was me. You know, so
I did watch
I've been around the block. Yeah, you need to watch that. It's quite funny when the judge bows and takes off, because what went across the bench that day, the bar rather, was an apostille copy of the birth certificate, the absolute proof of the fraud that they were trying to commit by trying to get me to consent to be that legal name. Mm-hmm. If I consent to be a legal name, then I am committing fraud. And people need to get this very clear. So don't just think that you're going to grab a document off my website and fire it in, thinking it's going to work for you if you haven't done any of the inside work, because it won't. I've had lots of friends, you want to call them friends, use stuff that I've written, and they never bothered to read it, and they wondered why they kept getting the stuff sent back to them. Mm. And it's because you're the power, not the piece of paper. That's a two-dimensional flat earth world. What you're doing with these little sigils and squiggles is you're putting your intent to paper. Now, I cracked the Phoenician code, which is how all languages work with sound, and everything is related, one thread. It works in every language. And that's what Roman law is based on, Phoenician. So I'll give you an example. When I say good morning to you, is that because the day just started or because I'm at a funeral with you? So if you don't make it very clear as to your intention, the sound is going to carry the intention that was hidden. So every time somebody is saying good morning, unknowingly, the intention that is also carried is the I hope you're sad.
Wow.
So we got to be very careful. You know, it's like here's a singularity word. I love this one. They're all singularities, but the some are easier to show than others. When something is brand new, that means it is something you haven't seen before. But when something is something you knew, it's past, so it's a memory. So something that is of the future is also of the past in the singularity. I live in the singularity, and that's what I deal on explaining to people. And it's very simple, and it's so simple, this is why it's hard for programmed. I was there, guys. You were there. We were all there. I was programmed, just like everybody else in the school indoctrination, the religion indoctrinations, all of the crap. I just broke free, and I found the key that says I'm done. No legal name, no game. They cannot touch anything of yours, even if it's registered, if you know who you are. They've got to get you to consent to be the legal name in order to steal your home, to steal your children, to steal anything. Because that's what these guys do. They're vampires and parasites. And the only way a vampire can feed on you is if you say, come into my house. And the legal name is the big RSVP. Come and feed on me. Steal all my stuff. And while I'm complaining and crying about it, it's my fault. I let you in.
That's right.
Legal name lets the vampire in.
And that's the entrapment.
That's it. You entrap yourself. And that's how they stay in universal honor. You got to do it to yourself. So I woke up to that and I'm saying, you know, I'm not going to hand the firing squad any more bullets to say, don't shoot me, because they're going to.
Right.
Right.
It's really simple. And I have laid this out in excruciating detail with lots of fun to read essays and documents. There are legal documents there that have been used in the past. Remember, I'm only in now. So these are things that were step by step. So what I ask people to do is read through it all step by step. Mm-hmm. And don't go looking for the gimme that's going to solve your little issue, because it's not your issue. This is a planetary. This is an issue that is involving all of humanity. So you better start thinking in terms of all of humanity, or you're going to end up still being fed on as a self-centered, selfish, egotistical little parasite that is materialistically driven, following everything that is deemed normal.
And that's
insanity.
Yeah, and that's what I was saying at the beginning of the program, is that the Earth is, or the humanity itself, is in a very precarious spot right now, where we have to make a shift. Otherwise, we're going down a very terrible road. I mean, we're mostly there now, but there is a possibility of getting out of this, and we have to change our way of thinking. Mm.
It's the key is there for people that want it.
Yeah.
And, you know, if here it is in a nutshell, and this is where people just need to ponder this and get the concept. Because I'll tell you, as soon as you get that click moment, you start seeing everything in your life is owned by another because you gave it up. Anything you register, you've given up. That includes all countries, by the way, that are registered through the United Nations. That is, oh, well, who does all the registrations? The crown. So everything on this planet. Yeah, do you know how to keep people from actually finding the truth in terms of a new world order? Tell them that it's still coming when it's been here all along. If you want to really define and interpret what Revelations 18 is saying regarding the Whore of Babylon and the Mark of the Beast, well, commerce is the Whore of Babylon, crown commerce. And, of course, you can't do anything in the crown or commerce. It's all about the merchants. Read Revelations 18 properly this time, and you'll understand what the mark of the beast is. The mark of the beast is a legal name. You're of the dead by consent. So don't cry to me because over 500 people a year are killed in Canada alone while they're incarcerated, because you're not killing anybody that wasn't already agreeing to be dead. You did it to yourself. I just stopped doing that to myself. I stopped cutting my own wrists. Literally.
This is a really, really jagged pill for people to swallow that have never heard of before.
Oh, boy. It's a tough one to swallow.
Yeah.
But do you want to know what the magic is, though?
Sure.
As soon as you swallow it, miracles happen. Because I'll tell you something. The universe, the all-pure, benevolent truth of universe, creation of all, won't stand with a liar. Would you?
Yeah, no.
Stand in the truth, and the whole universe comes behind you. And I'm living proof. And we had that chat the other night.
Yeah, and it's interesting that the truth doesn't need defending.
Nope.
Yep.
Yeah, that's interesting too. Yeah, we've heard that a lot.
The truth does not need defending. It's the lies that need defending.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So if one feels they need to debate something with me, they're not debating anything but themselves, because the simple truth is this. I stand in truth, and as a net result, the heart of all creation stands with me. I am an untouchable in this realm. Mm-hmm. The Red Sea parts before me. I walk and travel freely. I got treated like royalty at Mount Sinai Hospital because I didn't have a legal name. And all of these people that are saying, well, what happens if you don't have ID and you can't get the health services? Sorry, you're going to wait in line like the rest of the slaves while those that are living get looked after first. That's how it works. I don't know. I probably have it here. You want to see proof? I'll give you proof.
And in the meantime, I just want to remind everybody, if they want to call in and have a question for Kate, the number is 807.
You don't remember it after that nice little 4733-800.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, I'm not sure if you can see this, but it'll probably be backwards.
No, we can see it. Yep, we can see it.
Okay, see how old that name is that they had to use to get me through the doors?
Oh, move slightly to your... Yeah. They used Jane Doe.
Yeah, they used, more accurately, Doe-755, Jane, date of birth, 1900, January 1st. Yeah. Oh, age, 114 years.
Nice.
You can't make this up.
Oh my God!
Is that what is that? That's from the hospital.
That's the name they used for her when she went to the hospital because she didn't have one.
Ava told me about part of your conversation the other night, and you had to travel to England to
Ireland.
Sorry, yeah. Needed a passport.
Yeah, and I got this one on my terms, but you don't even need a passport.
Yeah.
This was 3 years ago.
Right.
When I talked to the British High Consulate, I have people ask me questions all the time about what I need. What do I do about this? What do I do about that? Well, the same thing that I did when I called you asking. You see, people won't do things for themselves. Mm-hmm. So I picked up the phone and called the British High Consulate. First off, they were trying to tell me that I had to get a British passport through Washington Direct Current. You might think District of Columbia, but that's part of the Triple Crown. City of London, state is a country, Vatican City is a country, and Washington, D.C., District of Columbia is a country. All birth certificates are kept in Washington Direct Current. That's how they feed from it, anagogically, spiritually.
Wow.
Okay, so my first reaction was, wait a minute, Canada is still, of the Commonwealth, and I have to go to the U.S., which is of the Commonwealth. You guys all think you got different countries. No, you're not. You're all citizens of the City of London State because you use a legal name. That's why these foreign agents call lawyers and thug judges and thug cops and everybody else can have their way with you because, well, you're in their jurisdiction by using their jurisdiction name that isn't yours, so you're already guilty of fraud, false impersonation. These are all capital crimes, boys and girls.
Wow.
That's why they'll kill you, because you're already dead by consent. So,
wow. Can I just interrupt for a sec?
Yeah. The British High Consulate confirmed everything I'm telling you. The guy's name was Page. I said, I have no wish to commit fraud traveling with a name that does not belong to me. It says clearly on the birth certificate that it is a Crown copyright held under seal, which is none of my business. Business, duality, state of. Don't do that. Sorry. And they agreed with everything. Yes, Kate, we don't want you doing that. And I said, well, you get me whatever it is that I need to get past your goonies that are ignorant of this. And guess what I got?
My God. And most people would
travel to Ottawa to get it. They had to see me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And most people would say, oh, well, we can't travel because we aren't going to be able to have our ID, which means we're not going to have a passport. Yeah. It's just not.
So we actually have a caller coming in.
Yeah,
Kate,
we do.
So
we have a call.
Okay.
We have a question for you.
Excellent.
Okay.
Excellent.
Hello. Welcome to the show.
Hi there.
Hi.
Hey. You have a question for Kate?
I did have a question.
Go ahead.
I've been recently pulled over for DWI and full charge for trafficking. And I've been bringing a bit of a cover meeting.
Okay, I really couldn't hear much.
I think what he said was he was pulled over for a DWI.
Yeah.
DUI, driving under the influence.
Right. Okay, well, I have a question for you. Were you under the influence? Were you drunk?
I was under the influence.
You were, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, then sorry, universe can't help you.
Okay. Yeah.
These are the choices that you got to make as a responsible adult.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm not being cruel here. I'm just telling you how natural law works.
Right.
Like I said, don't expect the universe. Now, that being said, spend a little time on my website, because if the message is going to get to you, it'll be there and the universe will deliver it, and then you'll know how to step forward. But take responsibility for your choices of the past first. Sorry, this game is not for children, and I was there, my friend, so don't even think about this being any form of judgment. It's not. It's merely showing the contrast of what we need to do as responsible kindergarten angels. This is a kindergarten for angels here.
Hmm.
Cool.
So,
okay.
Just spend the time reading and don't worry. If it is meant to be, it will. But this is where you have to resolve it within yourself. And then you make the choice of this, and this is where you stand in truth. Are you ever going to do it again?
No, clearly.
Well, that's where you need to stand, and you've got to stand on that with absolute certainty that it will never happen again.
Yeah, total conviction.
Yeah, total commitment to truth. Otherwise, don't expect the universe to help you. Actually, the universe will drop a house or two on you to wake you up.
Mm-hmm. I think that's what happened here.
There you go.
Yeah, well, no, that's good. You've had your contrast, so take the lesson from it. Let's move on from there.
Yeah.
Get to my website, do a bunch of reading, and we do this together. We lock arms on this. There's no judgment here.
Okay, thank you.
Cool, you're thanks welcome, so much.
No worries.
Wow. So I remember you saying the other night, Kate, when we were having our chat, you said you kept asking the same question over and over, and I just wondered if you could share that with our with our listeners, because I think it's really important for them to hear that.
Which specific question? There's a few. Oh,
are you the name?
Sorry, you just sent it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Here's the question to change your mind. Are you a legal name, or are you you? Choose. You can only have one.
Right.
Dead legal fiction, or welcome back to the land of the living, where you get treated like royalty in hospitals. Can I tell you what happened?
Sure.
It's very, very short, very quick. And of course, I had a couple of friends with me. One of them, actually, her mom ended up in an emergency ward in Mississauga the same night, and she's a registered nurse. Mm-hmm. And she got the runaround. She didn't get looked after. She even had to go back to get an MRI the next day and spent all day there and still didn't get the MRI. So let's compare someone that's a legal slave in the system with someone who says, nah, that's not me. I'm me, and I don't care. You as a public servant, this is where you finally make the public servants stand up and do their job, right? Because while you're a legal slave, they'll push you around. With me and those that, and there are many like me now that get this, you get treated like royalty. And it's not about getting treated like royalty. It's about being treated human for a change.
Yeah.
So what happened with me was this. While this registered nurse got the runaround on the same night, here I am downtown Toronto, Mount Sinai, in a city of 3 million people. Emergency room is empty. Unheard of. Okay. Straight to the counter. Got in there at 7 o'clock, and I was looked after and sent on my way by 9 p.m., 2 hours in and out. And I'll tell you what happened during that 2 hours, and you'll probably have your jaw drop, because not only did I get escorted in by an intern, I got put into the number one room for rapid assessment zone, room A. No sooner did I get in there that an intern showed up to examine, and then brought the ward doctor over, because he wasn't quite sure what was going on. Long story, it's no big deal, but let's just say it was rather interesting. So not only that, the doctor, after checking me, said, yes, we need to have a closer look at this. So they ordered an ultrasound, which the technician came down with all the gear. I didn't have to go there. They came to me. Had another nurse come in and take a blood test, which I had full analysis of my blood work while I was there. I had full urine analysis while I was there. I had no less than 3 nurses at any given point. I had a urologist, the floor doctor. I had everyone pretty much that was there come in to make sure everything was good, and everything just went like clockwork. And not only that, I got the required medication that I needed, and I also got, a prescription that actually got filled up by someone else. You wouldn't believe this if I showed you.
Okay, so I have a question. Your prescriptions, what was the name on them? That was the Jane Doe?
Well, again, they used the, because it's not even a legal name, they put, and it's all in lowercase, by the way, they used my sire name, which I will never tell anyone. I will only spell it. Because how I sound is not the same way as you, because you can't spellbind me. So here's how it's spelled. So they used Kate, my family name.
Wow.
And there's no ID attached to that. There's no registration attached to it. There's nothing attached to it.
Wow.
And,
okay, well, we have another caller on the line.
Yeah.
Yep.
Awesome. I love talking to people.
Yeah. So great. This is Micah. Okay, so go ahead,
yes,
Micah.
Yes, it's Micah.
Hi, Micah.
Hello.
Yes, hi.
Go ahead.
Go ahead with your question.
Yeah, my question is, I would like to open a restaurant, and how I can open a restaurant with your vision, with everybody needs my license, my driver license, my social security. I need so many papers to sign the papers to get the license for if it's restaurant for alcohol license, for the food and everything like that. How you gonna pass this situation?
Right. So how does she do that?
Well, you gotta stop being licentious.
No, I'm asking you.
Yeah.
Hang on. I'm gonna answer the question for you. Cold hard truth, baby. Here it comes. Well, first you gotta stop being a legal name slave, because as a legal name slave, you gotta follow all the rules. And of course, if you want a license, that comes from the word licentious, which means that you are a sexually and morally depraved criminal. So you gotta figure out who you are first. So I, and again, about opening a restaurant, I'm not here to promote people into opening up something that's going to create commerce and allow money that is actually created off your soul, my soul, and everyone else's soul, to keep that going. So what I'm going to suggest to you, to answer your own question, don't wait for me to answer it. You got to answer it for yourself. Get to my website and read. Because when you're caught up in the matrix, me trying to explain the matrix to people in the matrix, and I've said this before, is like trying to speak Portuguese to a Taiwanese duck. Eventually, the quacking finally starts making sense, but you got to get who you are first. So these are not legal remedies of working within the Whore of Babylon system. Sorry, I don't play that game. I don't commit fraud. And we have to take it upon ourselves to understand that. And Luciferian thinking is this, that I can outcreate creation itself. That's the Luciferian mind. All things are already created. Everything that you could ever imagine from infinite realities, infinite perspectives, is already there in the all mind. The Luciferian mind says, oh, I can top that. And of course, wait a minute, weren't you created by that? So that's basically, to me, is like the unruly teenager that knows everything, and I just tell him, well, quick, leave home while you still know everything. We're the prodigal sons and stars, divine feminine masculines, coming home. I just said, I'm good. Mama, Papa, heart of all creations got this one. And that's where you let go, and you stop worshiping the money. You stop worshiping the beast. You stop worshiping commerce. You stop being part of the system that allows for the harms against humanity. Just because you're the one driving the getaway car for the bank robbery doesn't relieve you of the responsibility of being part and parcel to the crime. So if someone is killed during the robbery, you're doing the time, same as the one that pulled the trigger. I just stepped back from that. And okay, people need to take the time to breathe on this, okay? Right. This is what I call drive-through truthing. I want all the answers now, Kate, so I don't have to do anything for myself. And I want that 12-course meal, honk, 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 at the drive-through window if you take longer than a minute and a half to share it. This is where Job, the patience of Job, must come into self. And stop trying to figure it all out, because you can't. You're trying to out-create creation. I simply allow it to happen, and miracles occur.
Well, I remember Mary Elizabeth Croft in her book. I mean, she talked about
that. Very good
that,
friend of mine,
where
yes.
She said, quit your job. Get out of the workforce. Just completely get out of the system. I mean, some people are going to be really freaking scared about that.
Not my monkey. What I can show you is how I did it and how so many others are doing it. What you've got to do is to belly up to the table and start looking at the cold hard facts for self. So you're going to choose one of two things: physical mortality or spiritual immortality. Your soul is on the line on this one. Choose. I chose. Easy peasy. I can't help people that are caught in the matrix. You have to figure that out for yourself. You have to decide whether it's okay to support
things.
All right,
it's
things.
Enough.
That's
thank
all.
You very much.
Thank you.
This is the cold hard truth I share all the time. Most people don't want to hear it, because what they want are the answers to keep going on with their day-to-day existences. Mm-hmm. And I totally get the idea. If you want to open a restaurant, then open it anyway. You don't need licenses. You don't need any of this stuff, but you better know who you are, because until you do, you're a legal slave, and they'll do what they want with you.
Yeah, because ultimately, if you still are going by your name, still in the system, but it's kind of like having one foot in, one foot out, right?
Okay, well, no, you can't have one foot in, one foot
out.
No,
that's what I'm saying. You can't do that.
Yeah. You can't, because the other foot's on a banana peel. I've heard lots of truthers try that angle. So here, let me share it with you this way.
Okay.
Okay, how do we do this?
All or nothing.
it is an all or nothing. And see, here's the thing. When people are caught in the physical matrix, they don't understand the spiritual side of things. They're still caught in a physical reality matrix. And they're used to have, they've been programmed. We've all been programmed to, well, we've got to do this and do that. We have to go get a job. We have to go get, these are all programs that have been instilled in us for thousands of years. And this is not easy for people to accept. I get it. But the choice is very, very simple. And this is that jagged pill of truth that you're going to have to choke down or walk away from. There's no gray area here. You are the gray area. You have to walk between the black and white. So you can't be one foot in, one foot out. But what you can do is once you get out, you set up your own reality around you. You don't need licenses. You don't need license plates. You don't need tickets, carpenters and all the rest of this. Listen, just because your diploma falls off the wall and smashes and burns, does that mean that you can't do what your diploma said you were capable of?
Right. And the other thing, too, I know this has come up a lot. You don't need insurance either.
Nope. Nope, not at all. See, but here's the thing. This is where the trusting of the heart of all creation comes in. Because the first thing people say, well, no insurance. What happens if you... See, you're stuck in the what happens if.
Yeah.
See, you're script writing. I don't script write. I just accept that all will be as all is meant to be for me to learn the lessons I need to learn to move me forward to get me home. I'm good. My cab driver knows the way home. Imagine you landing in, say, a city you've never been in before. Let's say you've never been to Hong Kong. You've never seen a map. And there's a specific address you have to get to. Are you going to come walking out and try to tell the cab driver how to get there? Or are you going to tell the cab driver where you need to go and let the cabbie take you? Because here's what happens when you start telling that cab driver how to get there and you don't have a clue as to how to get there. Every time you tell him, no, turn here. Oh, that'll take you off the yellow brick road and it'll take you into potholes and disasters and all the rest of it. And until you finally go, oh, okay, you can drive again. And then the cabbie takes you back on the road. I'm on that road. Interstate 60, yellow brick road, call it whatever you want. I know where that narrow road is. And go ahead, ask me if I'll ever deviate. No thanks, I'm good.
And you know what? The reality is that there's power in numbers, right, Kate? And you said there's a lot more people all the time that are finally standing up to their truth and reclaiming what you say, reclaiming their soul. So, I mean, I think for some people who just quite aren't there and ready to jump off the cliff, right? I think that there can be a big transition time that people need
Huge.
To maybe go through.
That's why I tell... Yeah. You see, when I hit people with this truth, it is so overwhelming and it's so undeniable. It is a self-evident truth. All of a sudden, the panic and mayhem mentally, the monkey, left brain monkeys start going off, going, what do I do with this? And what do I do with that? That's why I tell people, well, just breathe.
Right.
Just breathe. Take your time and then take baby steps. When you start taking baby steps towards this, I don't want to be a part of that fraud any longer. Don't worry, universe kicks in and goes, I gotcha, every time.
That's right. And if people want to, I firmly believe that for people, if they truly want to take this, which I think is a quantum leap, really, if they want take this quantum leap, then they better be prepared to make a quantum transformation inside themselves, because that's really where it has to come from.
That's where it starts and that's where it ends. Every contract starts and finishes here and here in the heart and mind.
Yeah.
If you are in agreement to something, then you are in contract with it.
That's right.
Fact.
Yeah, that's
fact. I just don't contract with the system. So this is why I tell people, please, just be patient. Yes, this is a mind-blowing reality check that everything in the legal world is pure fraud. Everything in the governments are all pure fraud. All of the police and the lawyers and all of it is all pure fraud, designed for one thing and one thing only, to feed on you as a parasite on the living host that you are. You mentioned there are strength in numbers. No, there is ultimate power in one, but you've got to find that one first. What we have in numbers is that beautiful sense of, hey, cool, we got some friends playing.
Community.
We're playing. It's where we come together and lock. And, you know, you've got your life path. I've got mine. We're all telling the same story from a different perspective. So I cannot stress it enough to tell people, just please, please breathe. This is overwhelming. It is. I know. I've been there. I jumped the Grand Canyon. When I said no ID, I lost it all. That's why I had to go with no ID to get that passport, and guess what? There it is. Right in front of you. My terms. So if you have any, for me, it's about going out to experience it. If you don't know what to do, then go and do it. Lose the fear, get in gear. Fear is illusion.
So I have a question, Kate. I know that some people are going to say, oh yeah, that tranny that's wearing the makeup and, you know, spouting all this crap, you know, how the hell do I know he knows what he's talking about? You know,
well, like, how the hell do you know what she's talking about? I am just a clue. This is what I'm trying to get across to people. I've known who I am my whole life. And I actually know the role that beings like me, and there are millions of us around the world.
Of course.
What our role is here. And it is about neutrality. It is about finding the balance between the masculine, feminine energies while everyone is still worried about penises and vaginas. You see, gender is between the ears. Sex is between the legs. So if you live in Scorpio, you're in for a bit of a hell. I choose to live in Aries, the Ari, which is the high priest. These are not coincidences. These are coincidences, and this is where phonics brings every piece of the puzzle together. Now, I have to ask you a question. Did you have any aha moments after our little chat the other night?
Oh, dear Lord. Let me tell you.
Now, this is for everyone. Was it overwhelming for you?
It wasn't totally overwhelming for me because we've
been on the edge of this kind of information for some time.
Been on the fringe more than anything. We
know that there's ultimate agendas.
You got to realize, Kate, we also homeschooled our kids because we didn't want them to be in a cult. We've been accused of being a cult.
A personal development cult.
You know?
Which is awesome.
But, you know, so we've been bucking up against it for a really long time.
Can I show you how awesome cult is? You see, everything is polarized, negative, positive, right? Oh, it has a negative connotation. Well, I'm going to show you why cult is the most beautiful and benevolent thing. Cult means to harvest. T, the highest note on the scale, called love, phonetically is law of the truth, very from verily. So you are harvesting the law of truth. How is that bad?
Interesting. Well, it's not.
That's definitely a different way of looking at it. Of course, I'm a cultist. just because it wasn't as mind-blowing as it might have been maybe 6 or 7 years ago, it still really makes one stop and breathe, just like you said. And we've had some interesting conversations for the last couple of days about, you know, what to do with it. Because I think information is just information until you do something with it.
Experience, that's the Christ consciousness. That's the Capricorn that rules the knees. And this is about getting on one's knees with regard of creation in order to be able to accept it. That's what humility is. The Luciferian mind is all about arrogance. The spiritual, benevolent God mind is all about humility. So what you do is you find the singularity. And, you know, people will hear me rant and rave on the air, which I normally we started early. It's only 6:55 here. That's right, Central, because you're 1 hour behind. So it looks like I might be starting right on time. If you want to guys want to go longer, let me know.
Yeah.
But when you see, what I've learned to do is I've corralled the ego. The ego I'm in control of now. I can choose whatever emotion I want to manifest, and I do it. And the only emotions I like are joy, bliss, love, and all the rest of it. And anything else that comes out of my face is all act, because I'm trying to talk to the ego that still needs that to react to. So I'll get your goat. I'll get your Christ consciousness. And I'll pull it out. I'll challenge you. And one of the things that I love to do is challenging with pure truth, because there's no denying it. And then you really start seeing the monkey spinning out. And I was a monkey brain. I could write a legal document that stopped. Well, I had 100% success rate up until they raided me. That's how big a threat I was. But they did it against universal law. So at that point, I already knew the system was collapsed. You can't do that and get away with it. Sorry, boys and girls. Creation doesn't work that way. You defied natural law. You came against someone that actually knew who they were.
So what you're saying then is people, regardless, like, so when you step out of the system, when you reclaim your who you are, then what you're saying is the only law you really go by is that universal law, and that even they, the powers that be, even they have to respect that. Is that right?
What you wish upon one, you wish upon self. That's why I only wish benevolence upon all. And guess what happens? That mirror reflects back, and boy, oh boy, the benevolence is just crazy awesome. This is the problem that people run into because they're still Luciferian. They're still thinking they need to solve everything. You don't have to solve anything. It's already been solved. You're the one that's running in circles, defying it. I just accept creation. It's beautiful. I go with the natural order of things. That is, let nature take its core, heart, say, himself, herself, itself, all of creation. Let nature take its heart of all creation. I'm good with that.
What I find really interesting about the phonetics, actually, and I guess I mentioned this to you the other night, but just for our, the people that are watching or listening, I just want to point this out, that because Kevin and I are NLP practitioners and we work at the level of the unconscious mind, that even though we don't consciously know what those words mean when we're using them, because we're going by the dictionary, meaning of them, mm-hmm. which is very limited in its scope. But when you don't understand on a conscious level what those words mean, our unconscious mind, which holds the memories of all the world, of all time, it does know.
Yep.
So we are unconsciously using words that could actually be damaging ourselves.
Not actually are damaged.
They are, yeah.
Okay, so here's how to break that spell. Let's break the spell for everybody. When you understand that each word has an equal and opposite intent contained within it, because it does, then you choose the intent of how you want it to be expressed. So you can contract with yourself that everything that I say is only of my intent, as per whatever meaning somebody else thinks it is null and void. I'll give you an example, the word mean. And oh man, the magic that you find when you start playing this game is crazy. But look at the word mean. Well, you have ME, which is magnetic electric, on, from the Anu, meaning heart or the divine feminine. So say what you mean and mean what you say, because everything you say is creation. Say himself, herself, itself, creation itself. Mean, magnetic electric, heart, creation itself. So this is why if the meanings can be corrupted, and an alternative definition or definition of Phoenician is intended in a subtle way, subtle, you might pronounce it, but in an undertone way, and you're not aware of it, then you are creating for another in ignorance of this. You're not ignorant of it anymore. Spell broken.
Wow.
Now, well, people suffer for lack of knowledge, I think was the quote.
Oh, absolutely.
Yep. All the great teachers told us the same thing. I just said, you know what? These guys know what they're talking about, and they're right. Mm-hmm. You know, and this goes out to anyone that, say, is a Christian or whatever. How about you start doing what Jesus, I call him J-Boy, he's one of my favorite truthers. Why don't you start doing what he said to do instead of thinking that he's going to come and save you? Because he ain't. That wasn't his message. That's the church's message. And then church will tell you, if you defy our message, see that cross with that body on it? That's what we're going to do to you. And Christ was teaching completely the opposite. So when you're not dealing with Christianity for the most part in church. Now, this is every religion, by the way, but you're not dealing with Christianity in a church. You're dealing with churchianity in a church.
Yep.
Right.
To make sure you keep emptying your wallets, thinking that somebody knows something more than you, while you go through your little rituals of on your knees, eat the bread, drink the milk, drink the wine, do this, do that, preach this, repeat this, do that, do the other, and go home and think you've had a good day. That's just retarded. That's insanity. Oh, but if you put on a fancy dress, of course, they don't know how to accessorize these guys, judges and clergy. They have no concept of accessorizing. That's my little training joke. Okay? And they put all these garbs and robes and everything else on to go, oh, look, we're different. We're special. No, you look like a bunch of clowns. Just like the Nazi uniformed SS uniformed police today. The nationalistic Nazi socialist. What is it with the jackboots and the bulletproof vests and all black and everything else? I remember a society like that. There's an essay on my kfgaia.wordpress.com website that is, what's the title? Let me see. Show Me Your Papers. Anyone that's dealing with the legal name and playing in the system and all the rest of it, you're all Nazi collaborators. Fact. How about you step out? Because here's the only time a public servant is going to jump is when you make them one by becoming living. You're not a legal name. You're a living soul. Now, I want to make sure that people understand this. Your name that was given to you by your parents, well, the intention was for your parents to give that to you. They didn't know they were giving up you, the body, when they registered it. So that's a fraud. But understand this. Until you break the program within yourself, and I tell people, call yourself something different for a while to break the legal name habit. Me, I was lucky because I never identified with the name anyway, the legal name. So go figure, right? So that's another clue for me and for you. But here's the thing. The name that your parents intended to give you is yours. But as long as it can be assumed and presumed by some legal monkey, by some cop, some bailiff, some judge, some lawyer, and while you still have things registered and you still don't know who you are, it can be assumed and presumed that you are the legal name. This is why once you understand this, you are now obligated under universal law to start taking baby steps. I didn't say jump the Grand Canyon here. Take the baby steps. And one of the first steps I tell people, if you want to just get a feel for this, go grab an old expired library card with that legal name on it and cut it in half. By your actions, you are known. That is your intent. And you have started cutting the strings of Pinocchio. Because what happens to Pinocchio when he tells lies? His nose grows, right? And he's a puppet, so he's going to get control. And the only way you can be the real live being is to cut your own strings.
And you know, the truth.
I like the analogy of using, here a bunch of people think that they're free. You know, those that are, they consider themselves free are the most enslaved, because all they are eagles flying just above ground level with all these threads attached to them. You got to start breaking those threads. And I help people cut them because I'm already flying. And there's many of us that are already flying. If you want a hand cutting those strings, I'm here. I got a beak and I'll cut any string you need. But you got to make one commitment and one commitment only. You better, and you cannot falter on this. This is the narrow road that few shall find and even fewer shall walk. You must stand in truth because anything else is a lie.
That's right.
That's great.
Well, I is it okay if we take an extra 5 minutes? Is that okay, Katie? I'm just asking my producer here.
Oh, whatever you guys.
You guys okay with it?
Whatever.
Okay, just five. Because I just want to back up a little bit, because I want you to, if you could, just let people know what happens when we are born, and because when we're born, are we not born free or sovereign? And then
no,
we become
no, not
a
at all.
Okay. To explain that then.
Not at all. Now, keep in mind, I'm going to say this. I have my normal radio show that starts 5 minutes ago.
Okay.
So what we can do is whatever time we have here, if I don't finish, I'm going to talk about this anyway. So if you want to get the real rangy training.
Yeah, we could flip over. Yeah, we could do that. Let's flip over. Let's do that.
So it's Blog Talk Radio, criticalmassradio.co.uk.
Okay.
So if you can go there, actually the best way to do it is Google Creative Gaia, because the links, the main link is the one you can listen to every night. If you go to the latest show, Blog Talk Radio, criticalmassradio.co.uk, or Critical Mass Radio, I think all it is, that'll bring you to the table. Don't worry, you'll find me. I'm really easy to find. Millions of us are at this table, okay?
Okay, cool. So let's do that. Let's let you roll over to that. And okay. We'll just... I have a feeling we're going to be continuing this conversation.
Most definitely.
I don't think it's going
away. What I ask you to do, you got the link for the show for tonight. I've already posted it on Facebook
and on
Skype. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the show by answering that question.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
So show up. I'll wait for you. And then we'll readdress the question of what happens from birth and how we get enslaved literally at the conception.
Right on.
Okay, we'll do that. Okay
we'll do
so
that, so
thank you. Thank you, Kate. We'll catch you on the other side.
Thank you. Love
okay,
you.
See you.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Wow. Alrighty then. You could tell that I wanted to carry on the conversation.
Yeah, of course. Absolutely. And we will.
Yeah,
we
there will. And there's so much to learn because, yeah. I mean, Kate's done so much research about the history of all this stuff. And like you said, he really believes he's broken the Phoenician Code, mm-hmm. which is you know, is so crucial to our understanding. So we're definitely going to have some more conversations with Kate of Gaia.
Yep.
And Kate's website, I know it was already put up, but we'll just mention it again. It's kateofgaia.wordpress.com.
Hmm.
And that's where all the information is that she referred to. And, you know, even all the essays that she's written and the documents and everything. So really, really some interesting
reads on
there.
Start doing some research on your own.
And I think that's really what it's about. And the one thing that I really like about what she likes to remind people of, which is know who you are.
Yeah.
Because that is not just key, even on this topic. That is just what we need to be doing.
Yeah.
Knowing who we are.
Yeah.
Right.
So thanks everybody for listening and watching. And we'll catch
next
you
week
time.
We have Barbara Marks Hubbard.
Barbara Marks
we do
Hubbard.
Have Barbara Marks Hubbard, so she next will be week. Here next week, and that'll be another mind-expanding,
yes,
higher
indeed.
Consciousness conversation.
Absolutely.
So we'll catch you next time, guys. Thanks
Thank
for
you very
being
much.
Here.
Thanks,
and,
thanks the gang. And the
we'll see. Yeah, thanks to our crew. Couldn't do it without you guys. And we'll see you next week at 6 Same p.m. Time. Eastern, right here on the Mind Vault, camptv.ca. Valet, open doors. Wish I go away, got what you was looking for. Now it's me who they want, so you can go and take that little piece of shit with you. Hey, I'm at a